Yo, what's up, guys? Welcome back to another What Sold video. I know I haven't done one of these in a while, guys. I've just been super busy with work and everything going on, but I am trying to bring you guys as much content as I can. Do all the old videos and you can kind of see my story grow from there. But for those of you that are new, my name is Tyler. I'm a part-time reseller out of Texas. Hit the subscribe button if you want to join the pick and ship crew, and also hit the thumbs up button if you like the video. And don't forget to comment down below and say hi. So we're going to do this What Sold video a little bit differently. I'm going to take you guys along with me and pull each item, kind of show you where I keep everything. We're going to see how you guys like that. And so just comment down below whether you like that way or the old way. And I'll keep doing it either way, whichever one you guys like. So let's go ahead and look and see what we sold over the weekend. So over the weekend, we sold a total of 27 items here for a total of $688.33. We're going to scroll down to the bottom here. The first thing that sold is this, and I'll put a picture here, guys, of the completed listing. First thing that sold was Hopalong Cassidy Antique 1940s movie poster from The Showdown. That was the first thing that sold, and that is actually right here underneath this box here. This was actually a return. We'll talk about that in a minute. And then this was a wrong address package. So the buyer had put a wrong address. But this is the first thing that sold, guys. This is one of my neighbors down the street. He had some stuff he wanted me to get rid of for him. So we sold this on eBay for him. Basically, what we're doing is I charge 20%. So 20% fee to list it and ship it and take care of everything else. He just gives me the item and he takes 80%. So after fees and everything. But yeah, this is really cool. It's called The Showdown by William Boyd, featuring William Boyd, who is, for those of you that know, is Hopalong Cassidy. So really cool. It's vintage. It's in pretty good condition. That is the first thing that sold, and we'll go ahead and get that shipped out to the buyer. So that sold for $50 plus shipping. The buyer's all in at $58.02. So we'll get that shipped out to him. All right, guys, so the next thing that sold was this lot of cards here. All of these cards right here. These are Conan, two all chromium cards. They're really, really cool. I mean, they're pretty interesting. So there's a lot of them here. This is actually part of the Marvel card buy that we did at the estate sale that time. We paid $120 for everything, and guys, we are well into the profit on that. I think we made close to $1,000 off of it so far. So so that's 1994 Conan Series 2 trading cards, all chromium, complete set of 90 cards. So there's 10 pages there. Sold for $19.99 plus shipping. The buyer's all in at $34.12. So we'll go ahead and get that shipped out to them. All right, guys. So the next thing that sold was Flat Out for Xbox, original Xbox, this game here. So it's Flat Out, online enabled for the original Xbox, complete with the manual. It's actually in really good condition. Some fingerprints on there, but the disc is near mint. Really, really nice. Okay. The buyer paid for that game $7.99 free shipping. So we'll go ahead and get that shipped out. All right. All right, guys. So the next thing that sold was a baseball bat. Let's get in here and get the bat. This bat right here is a DeMarini bat. Super nice. This needs to be re-gripped, that's all. And then what we'll do, we'll use this box here. You know what, though? I actually have these little tubes over here. Oh, I got that PlayStation 3 right there this weekend at a garage sale for $10. It works just fine. I already tested it out. I played a little bit of this game here on it. It's Uncharted 2 Game of the Year Edition. So I tested that out. Works great. played that for about an hour today just to see and make sure that the PlayStation didn't like crap out after a few minutes. But yeah, it works great. And I'll have that listed up on the store here pretty soon. But I have these tubes. And I wanted to test something with this baseball bat. So we're going to bring one of these tubes with us too. We're going to see what's cheaper. We're going to see if doing it in the priority box is cheaper or if doing it in the little tube is cheaper. So let's see. I'm going to test something out. All right. So we've got the baseball bat here. We're going to test whether it's cheaper to ship it in a priority mailbox or if it's cheaper to ship it in a tube. So let's go ahead and see. So it's going to be $12.15 to ship it. Wait, no. U.S. Parcel Select. USPS Parcel Select packaging is $11.90 to ship it out. We can save a little bit of money by doing it the other way in this actual tube. So, but he paid for priority mail. So that's probably what I'm just going to go ahead and do anyways. It's only a dollar more. But just so you guys know, it is a little bit cheaper just to get a tube that is the size of the bat, and shipping in that, it's gonna save you a couple bucks. But for sake of the customer, since he paid for priority, we're gonna do priority. Probably a 11x8x5 box. So that sold for $44.99 plus shipping. The buyer's all in at $59.69. total. So that was a dang good sell. If you find those out in the wild, guys, be sure to pick it up. The next thing that sold was Just Dance 2. This is brand new. It's never been opened. Just Dance 2 sold for $11, free shipping. We'll go ahead and get that shipped out as well. The next thing that sold was, this guy left a weird note. He says, "Hello, thanks again. Please, can you pack very well in a plastic bubble envelope so it can fit inside mailbox? Thank you again and have a great weekend." He must have a small mailbox or something. So Trackmania Turbo for PlayStation 4 sold, which is going to be this one here. Trackmania Turbo. Okay. So we'll pack that as small as we can for him to help him out. That sold for $8 free shipping. The next thing that sold was an official Wii controller, black. It's going to be over here, possibly. This one right here. This one here, this is just a regular old black Wii controller with a nunchuck. This sold for $12. Plus shipping. The buyer's all in at $19.05. All right, guys, so the next thing that sold, we're out back out here in the garage. The next thing that sold, let me set down the camera for this one. Hang on. All right. This one's heavy as hell. So this is a Mario Kart Wii bundle. It's the black edition and it comes with the steering wheels and everything. This is working great. I got it at actually garage sale yesterday for $20. Plus there was about four or five games in with it. Two of the game which already sold was the Mario game and the Just Let's Dance game or whatever. Both of those sold. So those took care of what I paid for everything. So this is pure profit. This actually sold for $89.99 plus shipping. The buyer's all in at about $114. So that's a really good sell. got some good stuff in there. All right, guys, so the next thing that sold was this copy of Britannica's World's Best Solitaire. This came from a lot of $50. That box that you guys just saw me get into, that whole box I bought for 50 bucks, everything in it. We've already sold tons out of it. I've probably already sold at least $500 or $600 worth of stuff. But slowly but surely, all those games are selling. And this is a vintage game. It's vintage Britannica's World's Best Solitaire for PC. This sold for $3.99 free shipping. So we'll go ahead and get that out to the buyer. All right, guys. So the next thing that sold was a Resident Evil 5 Collector's Edition. It's this one here. This is for Xbox 360, I think. Yeah, Xbox 360. It's complete. It's got both games and the manuals and stuff. So it's the tin edition. It's got the little tin. It's pretty nice. This sold for $10 plus shipping. The buyer's all in at $18.95. It's a little heavier than a normal game. That's why it costs a little bit more. So the next thing that sold for the original Xbox was Mortal Kombat Deception. This is right here. Mortal Kombat Deception. Probably gonna change out that case. I don't know, it's in the pictures. So we'll leave it like that. I'll just change it out. It's pretty simple to change it out. So yeah, we'll go ahead and change it out for the buyer. This sold for $12.99. plus free shipping. So we'll go ahead and get that out to the buyer as well. The next thing that sold was actually a really good buy, which was this original iPod. This is the Apple iPod Touch third generation. It's in really, really good condition. 64 gigabyte with a brand new pair of headphones. This one here sold for $50. Free shipping. So we're going to go ahead and get that out to the buyer. It works great, guys. It's in perfect condition. And I mean, this thing is nice. So we'll go ahead and get that out to the buyer. And guys, is this here? So a bit of a story with this. I shipped this out to a guy about 2 weeks ago, babe? The turntables?
Oh, yeah.
So about 2 weeks ago, I shipped this out to a guy. And he said he accidentally put the wrong address. Well, he wanted me to go in and change the address and reship it once it came back to the right address. Never ever do that, guys. Whatever you do, do not change the address that's on the buyer's account yourself. Always cancel the order. Make the buyer repurchase the item from you with the correct address. If you change the address on something like that, eBay will not cover you if something bad happens and he tries to say it didn't arrive or it was broken or whatever. eBay will not back you if you change that address. So just remember, cancel the order, relist it, make him purchase it again with the right address. So this has actually already been all the way to a place where he used to live. It got shipped back. I canceled the order, refunded him just the amount for the item. I did not refund him the shipping because that was money wasted. Then I relisted the item. He paid for the item again and shipping again. So we ended up not losing any money off that deal. Totally his fault. He understood it. He had no problem paying for everything again. This sold for $27.99 plus shipping. The buyer's all in at $48.82. So we'll go ahead and get this stuff shipped out, guys. But yeah, that's the order arrangement for today. And don't forget, today is Sunday, March the 8th, 2020. So this is kind of what sold over the weekend, but some really good sales. All right, guys, so we just got through packing up packages from this weekend's sales. We got everything ready to go out. Total of 29 packages. We had 27 when the video started. Then we had one game sale while we were packaging everything up and getting it ready. It took us a total of about hour and a half, almost 2 hours, to package up everything and get it done. But yeah, that's everything right there, guys. We're going to get it shipped out to the buyers. Hope they enjoy everything. So make sure you guys leave a like on the video, subscribe if you're new, and leave a comment down below if you liked the way I did things this time and walking to each piece and grabbing it and showing you guys where it is. So I think you might like that a little bit more. So just comment down below, let me know, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Have a good one.